Okay, hello, my name is Ricardo Gutierrez, and I'm gonna give you a brief explanation of what our solar concentrator project was for Engineering 154. That's the Physics 212 workshop. As far as what we used to construct this, I'm gonna first pass you over to Miguel so he could explain what he did with the aluminum sheet.
Hello, I'm Miguel Carrillo. And the first thing we did was we bought a 3x3 aluminum sheet and we shaped it into a cone. Also, we cut a hole in the middle so we could move it around so it could be the best fit for the angle towards the sun. Also, we shined the aluminum with some rim shine so it could have the best brightness for the sun to shine on the bottle. And now I'm gonna swing it back to Ricardo so he can explain the rest of our equipment of our experiment.
Okay, besides our cone, which Miguel here built, I went out and actually looked for an old school TV lens. And as you know, those old school TV lens serve as a magnifying glass. And the idea behind using an old school TV lens was that that would magnify the heat of the sun so that it would concentrate in here. And besides that, it would help the system retain some of that heat so it wouldn't escape. Besides the TV lens, we also used an old tire that we had lying around to try and preserve the heat. And I don't know, well, you can't touch this, but it's pretty hot. And we just set it up in a fire pit, angled it, and as Miguel said, you could move it around, tilt it so you could get the best angle of the sun. Besides that, we have a aluminum can inside, and we use the aluminum can because the aluminum, being a metal, is a really good conductor of heat. And we placed the water that we were going to use inside, and the idea behind that was that if you store it in a small container, the heat will be preserved even better. And as far as results goes, I'm gonna pass you back over to Miguel so he could explain what our results were for the system.
All right, let's start off with the starting temperature of the environment was 55 degrees, and also it was very foggy. We didn't even think we were gonna get any sun, but around 10:45, the sun started showing up, so we started doing the experiment. And the starting temperature of our water was 60 degrees Fahrenheit, so we decided to mark down the temperature at intervals of 15, so at 11, 79 degrees, 11, 15, 88, 11:30, 91, 11:45, 98, 12 o'clock, 101, 12:15, 105. So we stopped at 12:15. We went over 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So we stopped right there. So after we jotted down our data, we calculated Q, our heat. So first, what was given was the mass of the water, which is 495 grams. Specific heat of water, which is C, it's 4.18 joules gram divided by grams times Kelvin. Our T final, which we converted to Kelvin, is 311.483 K Kelvin. T initial, 288.795 Kelvin. And after we figured everything, we got everything that was given, we plugged it into our equation to find Q, canceled all the Q's and the J's. And we concluded that Q is equal to 47,175.0602 joules. And this concludes our experiment, and thank you very much.